A lot of the talk will be on trade. A lot of the talk will be on tariffs. What does it mean for your region? You are the longest-serving finance minister in your region. Do you worry that a U.S.-China spat that turns ugly will hurt the Americas?
It will, and we're concerned. There's no doubt about that. There was a summit of Americas a week ago. The presidents from the region talked about this. This is a main concern for many reasons. One, the U.S. market. The U.S. market is very important for many of our economies, including Colombia. So any increase in tariffs in the U.S. is going to be costly. Also, the fact that there will be a trade war, a response from other countries, that could also mean protectionism in other parts of the world.
But do you
think where is all this going to end? There will be more products coming into our markets at lower prices. That's also something we worry about.
But, Minister, do you think this will be a trade war, or is this just a president that wants a deal? Is this just a president trying to rattle the cage so that the U.S. is better off without a trade war?
We don't know where it's going to end, and we don't know what the ramifications of this could be. It could begin between the U.S. and China, but others may come in. And the world economy is going to be affected because there'll be more products that cannot enter the U.S. market or cannot enter the Chinese market if there is protectionism in China that will end up elsewhere, including our own economy. So our producers are concerned. I think, as with all trade wars...
But commodity producers or coffee producers?
Well, not necessarily commodity producers. Manufacturers, agricultural producers in general, because they are concerned that for their economies, for their own businesses individually, open markets are fundamental. And by the way, Colombia is an open economy as well. And many products from China, from the U.S., end in Colombia. So it's going to be disruptive.
If you look at the region, and then I will go on to Colombia and some of the finances there, but if you look at the region, are there countries or industries that will lose more if there is a trade war? And would anyone actually benefit from it?
No one is going to benefit from it. And
not an industry that's exempt, or that you don't see any glimmer of hope for someone.
No, I think the protectionism idea in general is going to be damaging for most of our producers. Why? Because they rely on the ability of selling their products globally, and also because for them to have more products coming into the economy because other economies have been closed. It's something that's going to be also negative.
Minister, let's talk about Colombia and your currency. It is the currency that has strengthened the most this year so far. At what point does it become too strong, and at what point should you intervene?
Well, that's a question everyone is asking me these days. But by the way, it's not just...
It's a good question.
Yes, very good question. It's not just the currency that has appreciated the most. It's also the market with the highest yield for foreign investors in local currency. So... that's why we've been getting a lot of foreign capital.
So will you do something about it?
Well, the currency has appreciated about 10% relative to where it was at the beginning of the year. We're still with a currency that is much more depreciated than it was 4 or 5 years ago when the commodity prices began to decline. So the currency is much more competitive now than it was 4 or 5 years ago. The Central Bank Board will meet next week. We will talk about this, not necessarily... we will intervene because we have to wait and see where is this going to.
A lot of it
is caused by high oil prices. So we will have to say, well, are high oil prices something that's going to stay for a long time, or are oil prices going to go back to the $65 range? So that's a question that still needs to be answered.
Okay, but how do you, you know, if you model where it is there a threshold? Is there a currency line? Is there a pairing that you target? And then you say, right, if it reaches that, I intervene. Is there a cap?
No, we have a flexible exchange rate, which has been very productive for Colombia. It was the first line of defense for our adjustment, and we like that. That's a very strong attribute of our fiscal and economic framework. Now, intervention. It's strong words, and we're not thinking about intervention at this point. We're helping some of the exporters that have been affected by the appreciation of the currency, like the coffee producers, or we're helping with very specific direct interventions.
You said that the central bank could talk about a 50 basis point cut. Why 50 and not 25?
Well, we'll see. We'll see what happens. But the main message is that there is space for the decline in the policy rate, and there is need for it as well because the economy needs some stimulus, additional stimulus. We're going to grow 2.7% this year. which is much better than last year, but still far from our potential.
Right, but we keep on being promised 3%. When are we going to reach 3% growth for Colombia?
Let's hope we can, you know, lower the interest rate, because with that, it's going to be much more likely that we get the 3% growth. By the way, 3% growth, everyone is predicting that and more for next year.
What does the central bank have a communication problem?
I don't think so.
The IMF seems to, you know, suggest it at the margin. Is that, you know, they say one thing and then investors are expecting, and actually you surprise them.
I think the one lesson that has been learned is that you cannot say in any communique or press release what you will do in the next meeting or so. Do not predict, do not anticipate, do not say, well, we've lowered interest rates and this is it. We're not going to lower it anymore. Because, you know, things change and the
but
economy,
you should guide them.
By
the Fed
nature,
guides.
Yeah, well, the guide is, with the information that we have today, this is what we think is going to happen. But never tie your hands. And I think that's the main message from the IMF.
Okay, do you think surprising the market is actually an effective tool, maybe?
No, I don't think it's an effective. But I don't think also that if the market is expecting something, you cannot do something different. One thing is the expectations. I don't know, the surveys, what the way the surveys are formed are essentially the opinions of others, but the central bank has its own mandate, and they have to decide that. They don't necessarily have to base their decisions on what the market is saying.
On the 3% growth, when are we going to see a dividend from the peace with FARC?
We're beginning to see it in some specific sectors. For example, tourism. The number of visitors to Colombia is growing at double-digit rates. Hotel occupancy rates are also quite high, the highest in our history. So tourism is the first sector seeing the benefits. Agriculture as well. Mm-hmm. We've had, you know, above the average growth of the economy, growth in agriculture. And we'll start to see more and more of this. Peace is very important for us, and investors are taking note of this, are bringing more capital to Colombia, so it's good.
Minister, you've been Minister of Finance for a long time. There are elections coming in Colombia. What will you do after?
Well, I don't know. It's a good question. I should start thinking about that. I just don't have the time. I have to basically take a vacation and then see what's next.
But private sector, public sector, maybe an organization such as the IMF or something like that?
I'm open. Okay. So I'm ready to hear to options. But, I'm in politics. I like politics. It's the air I breathe. So we'll see. We'll see what happens.
I mean, I know you were an effective communicator because last time you were here, you flew an economy and it was all over social. Do you fly an economy?
I actually got here. I got here at 2 a.m. last night and I came in an economy, so I'm tired.
So this is like the, you know, the austerity drive. You can see it through the minister's travels.
It's something that has been very effective in Colombia. We call it intelligent austerity. Cut where you can cut without affecting others and preserve government expenditures, especially in infrastructure and the social sectors. And it has worked formidably for us.